Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Prapti Sharma. I hope you all are fit and fine at your homes, enjoying at your homes with your whole family. And this time we're having a very interesting and fun-filled topic, which is the Freedom Fighters of India. You may be heard about this topic many times before since childhood. Haven't you? I'm sure you do. So what are these Freedom Fighter guys? There are many, they are very important, and they are many, actually, to be precise. Now, who are they? To be main, on the main content, they are Bhagat Singh, Subhash Chandra Bose, Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Dr. B. R. Ambedkar. In women, who are they? Rani Lakshmi Bai, Savitri Bai Phule, Sarojini Naidu, and many, many more. Actually, the count of these freedom fighters goes endless. Now talking about India got independence after doing a lot of struggle by many heroes, from which many of them are unsung. By unsung, I mean the heroes which are not known on the screen. The best example for this is, have you watched a movie? I'm sure you do have. But what are the characters, what are the people involved in that making in the movie? You must be thinking about the actor, actress, the director and all that. But you are wrong. There are many, hundreds of people, or not hundreds, but below 100 only. There are many people involved in that making of the movie. The photographer who is shooting the movie. But do you know the name of any photographer who is a movie shooter, or any other person who is not on the screen but actually played an important role in making that movie? So these people are known as the unsung people. That's what is telling in this line also. Many of them even lost their lives in this struggle. You must be knowing about them, and many of them must be in your family also. Now the two very, very, very important dates are given below. What are these? 15 August 1947 and 26 January 1950. What are these days, you ask? Not really. You must be knowing that 15 August is our Independence Day and 26 January is our Republic Day. Now, India got independence in 1947 on 15 August. The date is 15 August. And in 26 January 1950, our constitution or the rule book of India, by which India rules, came into effect in 1950, January 26. I hope it is very, very clear to you. Now, for coming back to our topic of independence, now our independence was very struggleful and very painful. Now talking about it, the first one, I make an agenda of it, though I made only four, there are many actually, but from starting, the starting of the India's independence was started from the revolt of 1857. You must be heard about it in the class 8, it was in there in the syllabus also. The revolt of 1857 was a revolt, the first step towards the India's independence against British or the Great Britainers. Now, in this revolt, it was the host of the main leader of this revolt was Bahadur Shah Zafar, who was the last Mughal emperor of India. After this revolt, he was imprisoned for his activities, under which Nana Sahib II and Nana Sahib, Peshwa Nara Sahib actually, Jhansi Ki Rani or Rani Lakshmi Bai, who was accompanied by another ruler who was Tantya Tope, who was a general of Nana Sahib actually, and many other big Ikdar and many other rulers of local rulers actually of different areas, who came up together and revolted against the Britishers. Next was to establishing in INC in 1885. In 1885, Indian National Congress was established. In this Indian National Congress, the main aim to establish Indian National Congress to raise voice on the behalf of Indian people. Actually, Britishers used to make the decisions which are only of their need or their profit. But for India, the people who are living, the citizens who are living in India should also be profited and should also be listened. So, for raising the voices of Indian people, we represent, we make an political party, which is Indian National Congress, still present also. It is a present president of Indian National Congress is Sonia Gandhi. You must be knowing about him. It was established to raise voice of our Indian people. Now, the non-corporation movement of in 1920, non-corporation movement was started by M.K. Gandhi or Mahatma Gandhi, who is the father of our nation. It was started by him and then Quit India Movement, which was also was the leader of this Quit India Movement, was Mahatma Gandhi. You'll be knowing about it in the future classes, or in future you may search about them also. Now, they are just four. I'm just talking about these four, but there are many. Other than these four, there are many other also who are there, and many other also which are there, the movements. Now, are talking about our heroes, there are many actually, but on a glance or a glam, I am taking about the six of them. Mahatma Gandhi, you must be knowing, he is the father of nature. Every kid from the nursery standard is told that the father of a nation is Mahatma Gandhi. Next up is Bhagat Singh. Shaheed-e-Azam is his nickname. He is Bhagat Singh, who was hanged up by the British government because he bombed the parliament. So he was hanged up by the Britishers. Next is the Mangal Pandey. He has a famous quote which is Maro Firangi Ko. He was also hanged because of attacking a British officer in Barakpur. He was also hanged actually. Next is Rani Lakshmi Bai. Jhansi Ki Rani, commonly known as Jhansi Ki Rani. He was not hanged, but he was died in the battlefield battling with the Britishers for the independence. He is the one of them who lost their lives for India's independence. He is the one of them. Subhash Chandra Bose, who is commonly known as Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, played a very, very, very important role in our Indian independence because he made the Azad Hind Fauj, based on which we get independence. Bal Gangadhar Tilak, who was commonly known as Lokmanya. Lokmanya means the person who is liked by every people, most of the people actually. He was named Lokmanya by Mahatma Gandhi actually. He also lost his life in the battlefield by battling against the Britishers. I've taken only two of them, but there are many. I've taken about the two main leaders. Now, talking about Mahatma Gandhi, as mentioned earlier, he is the father of the nation. Mahatma Gandhi has a full name, M.K. Gandhi, which is Manmohan Das Karamchand Gandhi, who was a famous Indian lawyer. He was given the title of Bapu from Subhash Chandra Bose. He was born on 1869. Then he went in 1887. He went to England to study law. In 1896, he again returned to India for taking his wife and children to South Africa, to be precise. In 1899, an outbreak of Boer War was then in South Africa, in 1920, he started the non-corporation movement. In 1924, he did a 21 days fasting. He was on fast on a hunger strike actually for 21 days to behold the Britishers, to make him डू वॉट ही वॉन्टेड. वॉट वॉज महात्मा गांधी वॉन्टेड? ही वॉन्टेड ब्रिटिशर्स टू डू वॉट ही वॉन्टेड. सो फॉर दैट ही डिड द हंगर स्ट्राइक. एंड आफ्टर दैट इन इन थर्टीन ऑन 30th January 1948 ही डाइड. ही वॉज शॉट अप बाय अ पर्सन while he was walking actually. Now the next unsung hero, actually he is an unsung hero, who is the Subhash Chandra Bose. Very less people know as compared to the Mahatma Gandhi actually. He founded the Indian Army, Indian National Army, which is commonly known as Azad Hind Fauj, to throw over British Empire from India and came to acquire legendary status among Indian masses. It has a very long story how he founded Azad Hind Fauj, and by doing a lot of struggle, let me tell you about it from the beginning. He was born on 1897 in Cuttack, which is in present day Orissa. You must be knowing about it. In 1919, his parents sent him to London for studying, actually for preparing for civil services. In 1920, he got the ICI job in the civil service also, but listening to the crisis which are there in India, in 1921, he returned to India, resigning the job of the London. After that, he joined the non-corporation movement started by the Mahatma Gandhi. Then he was doing a work for with the help of his brother who was Sujit Chand Bose. He was supported financially and morally by his brother, elder brother. After that, he also joined the Indian National Congress in 1938. Before that, he was imprisoned. Why he was imprisoned was the main reason was for protesting against the British. He was protesting against the British in Bengal, so he was imprisoned. After that, he also did hunger strike to get out of the jail. Actually, in his struggle of freedom, he was imprisoned 11 times. Can you imagine a person being imprisoned 11 times just for one aim, just for making India's independence? Most of the time was the false statement given for the Subhash Chandra Bose, for which he was imprisoned by the Britishers. In 1938, he joined Indian National Congress. He was even the president of the Indian National Congress for 1 year, but because of his differences between Mahatma Gandhi, he followed the instruction given by Mahatma Gandhi and resigned the Indian National Congress. After that, he escaped from India. Being in high touch with the Britishers, he was in house arrest, as he also did hunger strike in the jail. So he was in house arrest, and after that he escaped from the Britishers to India. It has a great escape. For his escape, he has a great journey, for which I'll make another video and tell about it. After that, it is told that he died on 18 August 1945 in a plane crash, but actual theory about it is still not known actually. Now, he was very, very renowned one. Now, talking about the timeline of whatever this did. Now, the first is Rani Lakshmi Bai, who has a terrain of 1854 to 1858. He has a terrain of it. Bhagat Singh was having its terrain. He clicked the picture in 1929 and was died in 1931 actually. After that, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, he has a terrain in 1920, and Subhash Chandra Bose has a terrain in 1941, from the year he escaped till 1948, till he died. Actually, now next up is the India's map after partition. The partition of India was division of British India in 1947 into two independent dominions, India and Pakistan. The dominion of India is today the Republic of India, and the dominion of Pakistan is the Islamic Republic of Pakistan and the People's Republic of Bangladesh. Actually, Bangladesh was earlier known as East Pakistan and the other one was known as West Pakistan, but now it is a separate country which is known as Bangladesh. And you may see the India's map in which no Bangladesh and Pakistan is mentioned. Now we are having giving an example of Kerala, the state details of Kerala. It has an area of about 83,863 square kilometers actually. Here it has a population of 3. It has a population, the male population, female urban population, and the sex ratio is 1,084. You may see that. Now talking about Indian forces, Indian Army, Indian Navy, and Indian Air Force. You must be knowing there are three forces actually. Who is the main of the Indian Defence Staff? Currently it is General Bipin Rawat. In Indian Army, the main chief of Indian Army is General Manoj Mukund Narvare. The chief of Indian Navy is Admiral Karambir Singh. The main chief of Indian Air Force is Marshal Vivek Ram Chaudhary. Now, talking about the first in India, the first president of India is Dr. Rajendra Prasad. The Prime Minister of India, the first Prime Minister of India is Jawaharlal Nehru. The first Lady Prime Minister of India is Indira Gandhi. The first Lady President of India is Pratibha Patil. The first Army Chief is Kundardera Mandapa Karappa. And the first Naval Staff Chief was Khatri. Was commonly known as Khatri. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe my channel. If you like that, please follow. Thank you very, very much.